So this is a Tone Orca 001, which is very close to another microphone that's on the market. I call this really the budget version of that mic. And if you guessed the Hyper Quadcast, you are correct, because that's the first thing that came to my mind when I was looking at this microphone. Before I get into the review, I do want to mention that Toner did send out this mic for me to review. However, I'm not getting paid for this video, and I'm going to say whatever the hell I want about the mic. So if it's good mic, I'll let you know, and if it's crappy, I'll also let you know. So in the box, you get your mic that comes with a stand and a USB-C connector, which is always nice to see than having a traditional USB connector. And it also comes with this small attachment that you can use to take the mic off the stand if you want to attach it to a boom arm. So here are the physical controls on the microphone. Just be aware there is no software, so you can't really tweak all the settings that you would like on a microphone that's going to cost you a bit more. But if you just want a plug and play microphone, here's what you get. You have your mute button that's directly on top of the microphone that you can just tap in order to mute yourself. And I think this is a great place to have the mute button. However, with this microphone in particular, you do hear yourself tapping that mute button before you actually go mute. So you hear a loud thump and then you'll go mute on the other end if someone's listening. You get to control your gain with these two buttons on the microphone, and it's color coded to a specific RGB color, which is kind of nice. I mean, you get some RGB with the microphone, but one thing I don't like about it is that you can't really tell how loud you're actually getting unless you remember what color is specific towards which level of the gain is at. Then maybe you can understand where you're at with your gain levels, but I see this just being as set it once, leave it there, and don't ever change it again. And also, when you're trying to change your gain on the microphone and you're pressing these two buttons, you hear it on the other side. Instead, I wish they would have implemented a dial on the microphone, similar to my dial that's on my Blue Yeti. You get to see how loud you're actually making your voice sound, and I think it's just a much better experience than having to press a button multiple times in order to get yourself louder. The best part about this microphone is probably its noise reduction feature, where you can just press and long hold that button and it turns it on, and it reduces a decent amount of background noise if you're using it in a loud environment. So I did test out this mic on a competitive match on Valorant, and no one seemed like they had an issue hearing me. They didn't say I sound distorted. I even hopped onto Discord to ask my friend how I sounded like, and he said I sound fine. However, when I asked him did I sound better or worse compared to my Blue Yeti microphone, and he said I did sound a little worse. It's not as clear, and that's as to be expected from a budget microphone that's a little cheaper than your more expensive microphone that's out there. And here's a sound test. You can be the judge of how I sound, and also I'll show you what I mean by the mute button. You can hear the sound before I actually go mute, and also the gain control, where you can hear each click of the button as I'm increasing or decreasing the gain of the microphone. Okay, so this is the mic quality of the Tone Orca 001. Now I have it really close to my mouth right now, but usually if I'm using this mic, or if you're using this mic, you would typically just have it here on the desk. So I'll be playing my game. This is how I sound from just speaking from a distance. And I have this on the max setting right now. So now I'm gonna show you that dump sound I was talking about when you use the mute button. So I'm gonna go mute right now. All right, and you probably heard that dump. And here's me just changing the gain on the microphone. So while you're talking to someone and you're trying to change the gain, this is how it sounds like. So you hear those clicks as you're changing the gain, which can get quite annoying. So one last test I'm going to do here is going to be the noise reduction button that I have built in on this microphone. So here's me typing on the keyboard in the background. You probably hear the keyboard. Now I'm going to turn it on. It's on. And let me know if that sound any better and if the noise reduction actually helps. One other issue I had with the stand was being able to detach the microphone from the stand. And it was supposed to be really easy according to the instructions. You just turn this knob, get that screw apart, and then you put the other piece that comes in the box onto the microphone and then onto your stand. But I couldn't get it off. I only got half of that knob off. The other piece, the metal piece that screws into that knob, wouldn't come off, so I didn't end up using that option where you can put it onto the boom arm, and If you're going to buy this mic, that might be an issue that you're going to run into, but if you're just going to use it as a standing mic with the stand that it comes with, then you won't have an issue. And I forgot, you can't change the volume of what you're listening to unless you go onto the desktop and manually do it. There is no dial or button on the microphone, so maybe you have something on your keyboard that allows you to do that, but if you don't, it is unfortunate that you do have to go onto the desktop in order to change that. And that's pretty much it. When it comes to all the features on this microphone, you will be limited on features because it's a more budget-friendly option in comparison to like your Blue Yeti and your Hyper Quadcast. So if you just want a plug-and-play microphone, plug it in, forget about it, have all the features on the microphone, don't have to worry about software, then this is a good option for you. And if you're not a big fan of headsets like me, ever since I switched over to IEMs, I think they're a much better option to pair up with an external mic than using a headset. You're going to have better audio for games, and also you're going to have better input audio because let's face it, microphones on the headset sound terrible. It sounds like you're working at a fast food restaurant trying to take an order at a drive-thru. So would I recommend this headphone? And to be honest, it really depends if you're on a budget. I think if you have a limited budget to work with, then this microphone can be the option for you. You can use the rest of the money to get a budget pair of IEMs, which will pair really well. So that's all for this video. I don't usually cover microphones on here because I'm not an expert in them, but if I do get products like these and I find that they're interesting and I do use them as part of my desk setup or gaming needs, I do want to show them here on this channel. So hopefully you found this helpful, and if you did, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and subscribe down below for future videos. I'll see you on the next one.